So welcome everyone, a formal welcome. Thank you for being here with all of us. My name is Amanda Ree. I'm the founder of Sama Dog Wellbeing. Sama Dog is dedicated to living a natural, healthy, and spiritual life with your dog friends. And I'm honored to be here with all of you today. Anytime that we can share in this awesome conversation and of wellness and connection and our animal friends, I am game because it's a very authentic and heart-centered group that typically comes together. So thank you for being here. Are you so excited for today and like dog talk for many hours? Show me if you are. I know I can't really see you, but I think I can see like raise of hands or something like that somewhere around here. Oh yeah, there we go. Some yeses, that always works. Feel free throughout this conversation. I'll lay the foundation first and just give you a bit of an overview of Ayurveda, of the doshas. If you've never heard of any of this, no worries. I will break it down briefly. And then we'll get into the different doshas and some food specifics. I've got some show and tell for y'all. And then we'll get into lots of questions if you have any. So first, before we do anything, I think it's great to just settle in and center. I love to do that as a meditation, yoga, and Ayurveda instructor. I love to kind of just bring us together and connect at the start of anything. So why don't we do that now? Just close your eyes wherever you're at, as long as you're not driving or walking and it's safe to. Just close your eyes for one moment. And let's enjoy 5 deep full breaths together. Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. As long as that's comfortable, just let it go. And a few more like this, in through the nose and out through the mouth. You can sigh it out as you exhale. And with every breath in, notice how you can land into this present moment a little more fully. All the doings of the morning, getting onto the platform, the uncertainty of something new. With your next exhale, just let it all go. Here we are now, here together, connected, woven. One more big breath in. Long exhale. Centered in your heart, slowly opening your eyes. Thank you. I hope that felt good to you too. Always nice to connect from that space. And I think it gives you a little feeling too of kind of what Sama Dog, what my work is all about. Yes, we will get into nitty gritties of food and behavior, training, daily routine, how we handle our dogs, how do we communicate with them. That is very much what we talk about. It's really very much oriented to the whole lifestyle. That is what is, I think, unique about Ayurveda, which by the way is the healing science of India. That it's a holistic healing system. It is the oldest on the planet, at least 5,000 years old, maybe even a little longer. So there's a lot to say about Ayurveda, obviously, over all those years, but yet it is very simple. And what it is unique to most other holistic modalities is that it's inclusive of all modalities. It's inclusive of all aspects of our life and our environment. So oftentimes we're talking about our own selves, our dog's body and their mind and what's going on with them, and not as much considering what's going on around them. So literally physically in their environment and in the greater extension of our planet and nature. That is what Ayurveda means. It is a Sanskrit word, since the tradition of Ayurveda is rooted in India. The ancient language of India is Sanskrit. So Ayurveda, if you break it down into the two words, Ayus, A-Y-U-S, is life, and Veda, V-E-D-A, is the wisdom or the science of. And so it's the science of life. The wisdom of nature is what I like to call it. And it shows us, it guides us how to recognize what our unique nature is and what the, you know, speaking of nature, really getting into the elements, the 5 elements that are on this great planet and make up everything. Those are space, air, fire, water, and earth. And so fundamentally, what Ayurveda is guiding us to understand is how we all are a combination of those 5 elements. And sometimes, in every case, some of us have certain elements higher than others. So that's where it becomes, Ayurveda becomes a very customized healing science. And that's what's cool about it, is it's totally unique. It's personalized to exactly what your dog needs right now. And as I mentioned, it's inclusive. So I love the way that actually, even when we get into food, we can inclusively speak about it in a way that will incorporate everything you're learning today through this conference. Because what you're going to do here in our context of Ayurveda, you know, certainly we can change the foundation of the food, speaking just of food, we can change the foundation of it. But what we also are into is putting toppers on. So you can start with any foundation, whatever's suited to you, whatever your dog likes, whatever you're leaning towards, and then you can put specific toppers on there that are going to balance your dog. Essentially, when it all boils down, that's what it's about, it's balance. And that is what Sama, by the way, means, S-A-M-A, the name of our company. Sama is your essential balance or your essential nature. And coming back to that space, that state of equanimity. So that's what's going on with Ayurveda overall. Let me first just tell you, before we get into the details of doshas, a little bit about myself so you know a bit about my background. So I have been a practitioner of Ayurveda, yoga, meditation for almost 20 years now, teaching it for humans. And it was probably 10 years ago that my husband and I started bringing in foster dogs through rescue work. And we started a rescue organization and had a house full of furry friends of all different kinds and shapes and sizes and stages of life and stages of health. And we really started to see the way that, you know, it was almost like a light bulb went off one day, because prior to that, I did not see it. But then one day I did, the way that Ayurveda applies to the animals so well, because they too are an expression of nature. They too are an expression of the five elements. And when we came to see that, we started to notice, just like with humans, the same kind of conditions were going on when they were out of balance. So when I got my Ayurvedic goggles on, that's what I like to call it when you get this way of looking at the world. When I got those goggles on and I started to look at all the rescue dogs that came in, I could see some of those imbalances, like a lot of nervousness and skinniness and shy and shaky. That's Vata. We'll get into it if you don't know these yet. You know, recognizing that kind of characteristic within some dogs, right? Or then you have your dogs that are more intense, more focused, a little more heated, very clear in their keen, sharp. So that's a Pitta dog. And that is what we would see sometimes when the rescues would come in and they would have some reactivity. Oftentimes you kind of sense that fiery side of them. And or you would see sometimes a dog that didn't want anything to do with you. They wanted to put their head down and kind of turn away. They were a bit withdrawn. And that is like a Kapha dog. That's our third dosha. Again, we'll get into these, but just showing, like, without even knowing the doshas at all, you actually do know them already, because you see these themes within our canine friends, within our human friends as well. So once we started to notice that, we decided to do more. The world needed this. The dogs were healing unbelievably well and so quickly. You know, years we'd been doing it and giving all the medicines and all the typical protocols, but when we worked in the methodology of Ayurveda, it was a game changer. The animals were healing so much better. Their attitudes were great. Our connection with them and their trust in us deepened exponentially, and it made a huge difference. So it was about that time that it kind of just happened. I had a full-time job at the time as the vice president of the Chopra Center for Wellbeing. It's Dr. Deepak Chopra's organization. Some of you are likely familiar with our great teacher, Dr. Chopra. And I've been very close with him for all of these years and studied closely with him. And I was the vice president. And when I came to see all the beauty that this had, this work at, in application to animals, I knew I had to put it out in the world. So I quit my job and I started Sama Dog. And it's been several years now, and it's been an extraordinary adventure. And every time I get to share it, I'm so grateful, because it means that your dogs are going to be able to glimmer some of this into their life and to be more balanced and just be paid attention to, maybe in a bit more conscious way. And that is a big deal for our dog friends and our lives. So, you know, what we really come down to with the conversation of Ayurveda we come down to this foundation of the doshas, as I've mentioned. So what is a dosha? D-O-S-H-A. Dosha is a mind-body type. Dosha is a mind-body type, and it is the constitution or your dog's personality of their physical body, but also of their mind, their emotions, their behaviors. So all of us have doshas. There are three. They are vata, pitta, and kapha. We all have all three of them. It's just most of us have one that's predominant or two that are pretty predominant. Now there's a small sliver of the population, whether we're talking about humans or dogs, that have all three equal in their being. But for most of us, we will identify with one, maybe two of them. And we'll go through them. So of these three mind-body types, why it is so important to know is because then from that information, from knowing their dosha, we are able to select basically everything in our dog's life. So we'll focus mostly on food today, obviously the context of our event. But what we also can apply Ayurveda to, again, every aspect of their life. So the way that we're interacting with them, we're training them, we're communicating with them, especially into daily routines, care routines, kind of how you're interacting on the day-to-day, and then into the whole sensory world where we work with aroma and smell and sight and touch, and how that has a very strong influence, just as strong as food does through the sense of taste. The other senses do also. So that is a great way to influence our animals. And then into that spiritual or kind of ethereal, energetic realm. And it incorporates all of that. So even for the doshas, certain practices, meditations, affirmations that you would do for vatas versus pittas versus kaphas. So I know in the very beginning, if you're brand new and you've never even heard of Ayurveda and you're in this conversation right now, it might be like, what the heck is she talking about? But please do know that the more you stick around with us, the more you get used to these terms. But really what's most important is it's nature science. It's been around forever, and it's been around far longer than our Western system that most of us are used to. And because of that, there's something to be gleaned from its wisdom. And when we do that, our animals and ourselves can have a big change in our life. So the most important thing to take from this conversation, in my opinion, is learning your dog's dosha. Now we can do that. You can do that after this, after today, or after this session. When you have a moment, you can go to our website. It's sama.com/quiz. And maybe Stephen, you can write that into our chat there, so people just have that link. And so /quiz, and that is where you would be able to go through and do your whole do the quiz. It takes just about 3 minutes, and you'll learn there if what your dog's predominant dosha is, and then you'll be able to make your selections accordingly. That said, through this conversation, I of course hope that you're able to pull out clarity just through the conversation on what your dog likely is aligned to. It'll make more sense as we keep going. So everything to do with your dog's food can have to do with your dog's dosha. And the reason for that is because, as mentioned, we are balancing through the senses, and with dogs and humans too, we're very aware of what comes in through our sense of taste. And we know that that has a big impact on us. It has a big impact on our physical body and also our mental state, energy, the energetic connection to foods, just foods that are spicy and they kind of make you a little bit more intense, or foods that are heavier or kind of more sugary make you slower and more sluggish, right? Well, all of that weaves right into the doshas and how the doshic themes are connected to your animals. So you'll see that. It'll just kind of make sense. So that's what I mean by, if you've never heard of this before or you don't know these terms, you still know the science. You just haven't known the ways in which you could put languaging to it, or that it was kind of a constructed system already. But it'll be pretty interesting. It certainly was that for me when I got into Ayurveda. I'm like, oh, I already knew a lot of this. I just didn't know there was a system. So when speaking of food, and please feel free as we're going through this, ask me any questions that you have. I'm into the chat, and of course at the end we'll have time. So we, through this conversation with food, we want to get into each one. So first, vata. So that dosha is spelled V-A-T-A, Vata. It's a combination of air and space. So when we're talking about those five elements, air and space come together, creating a pretty airy animal. So what does that mean? It means like light and fun and easy and joyful, playful, very adaptable, easygoing, the life of the party, always down for a good time. And that is a Vata being when they're in balance, very outgoing, creative, friendly. But then when out of balance, meaning the air becomes too much, it gets accumulated, over accumulation of air, then what does that look like? Well, think of like a balloon that's become untethered, it starts to float away, right? So when that energy moves into our animal, that overly light and dryness, they start to physically get dry, get ungrounded, get unstable, unrooted. And with that, the emotions of anxiety, fear, phobias can all start to come up. So this is what a Vata imbalance would look like more in your dog. So just tell me in the comments now, who, say a yes or Vata, V-A-T-A, if you think that your dog has some Vata. These dogs also like to talk a lot. You know, Vata people talk a lot. Vata dogs like to talk a lot or just whine. They're very vocal. So if that kind of sounds a bit like your dog, all right, Carol and Duff, that's great. So it sounds like your dog might have a little bit of Vata in there. That lightness. So, you know, when you're thinking breeds, and we don't want to necessarily associate a certain breed with a dosha, because anybody can be any of the doshas. And as I mentioned, we all have them in us anyways. They're just in different quantities, or I like to say a different recipe. So what recipe in general, though, for a breed is typically Vata? I would say like Afghans and standard poodles, greyhounds, dogs of that nature will those like kind of skinny, long-limbed, light dogs are those of Vata nature. So when it comes to food, this is Benny, by the way. Hello, everyone. Benny the Terrier. So when it comes to, oh, Chris says he definitely has a Vata dog. That's great. So when it comes to their food, again, you can take into consideration everything that you learned today, customize what you like on the base. You can kind of align the entire meal to your dog's dosha, or as mentioned, just some toppers. So some good idea for toppers here. First, with Vata, because they're so airy and light and dry, we want to, and I always say it like a mantra almost, warm, moist, oily. Warm, moist, oily. That's what we want to do all the time for our dog friends that need that grounding. So just warm water, you know, just using your kettle and warming up the water, not necessarily boiling, but just using that hydration to put on the food is great. And then we've got some oils, you know, you guys know probably lots of good oils for dogs. Plant-based oils are good, fish oils are great, but oleate them is going to get them in their body and on the earth more. So we've got, you know, Nordic Naturals is one of the best omega oils out there. So I like the cod liver oil blend so that it gets the vitamin D in there as well. But they've got also just your regular like omega-3s. Oh, good, Stephen, that's what you use? Yeah, that Nordic Naturals is extremely good brand, very high quality. Another for Vata, each of the doshas have different oils that are most appropriate. But for Vata, what's ideal is sesame oil. I'm just going to show you guys so you kind of see some of these and, you know, likely you've got a lot of these in your cupboard anyway. And another one, avocado oil is a good one with Vatas. Vatas and pittas are good with avocado oil, I mean. And then ghee is another one. Do you guys know ghee? Tell me if you are familiar with this product. See, my light is on. There we go. So it doesn't have to be this specific brand, but ghee is excellent for dogs in small amount. If your dog is overweight, definitely a little even smaller amount. But if your dog is of good weight, yeah, Kathleen, you like ghee? Great. Yes, clarified butter, exactly. So clarified butter just means that all of the impurities have been taken out. You can make it yourself. You can buy it at the market. It's pretty expensive at the market, so it's good to make it yourself. But very good because it's basically just the oils of the of the butter, and then what's extracted is just like this very clear, clarified substance, and it is so good for vata, for grounding. It's very tasty. It smells super good. I wish I could give you guys a sniff of it. Oh, it smells very delicious. So you might find for dogs that are fussy and finicky, like vatas tend to be. See, Benny liked it. His little nose went up. It'll get them eating. So you can just kind of smear a little bit on the top of their food. That's a great way if you've got a fussy dog. Yeah, great to cook with because you can heat it up really high. So those are some ideal foods for vata because they're so grounding. You can kind of see that, right? Another one is sardines. Just any old sardines, ideally in water. Oil is okay too, because you're just giving a little bit, as long as you've got like organic, good selections of the brands here, you're good with that. And those are some great ways just to kind of initially add to your dog's food to create that solidity, that hydration at their core of their being, which will actually reduce the anxiety in their mind. That's the whole body-mind connection. It's really quite fascinating. And it absolutely works for dogs too. So then moving on to our fiery friends, which are pitta. Fire and water come together to create pitta, P-I-T-T-A. So these animals are engaging, smart, athletic, love eye contact, love to be focused in that way. They want to work. They want a job. They love agility. They are the working breed. So they are the dogs that literally are out there like bomb sniffing dogs and, working with in many cases therapy dogs, working with investigations of crimes and finding lost persons, you know, all of those kinds of dogs that like to have a job like that. That is probably showing us that they are pitta dosha. So when in balance, so outgoing, courageous, intensely passionate, that's what you really see in that fire. This little guy on my lap is that. So, you know, such a dear friend, like he's so connected to me. But when out of balance, what happens? They get very intense. The fire gets too much. They get reactive, angry, aggressive, reactive, or I said that, and unpredictable. So those are tendencies of our pitta friends when out of balance. So when we're thinking of breeds, just kind of generally, again, think of like shepherds, Dobermans, Rottweilers, pit bulls, many cases, terriers, like this little guy, and he's sort of, you know, he's Jack Russell mix, so give him a ball and, you know, you can see the fire in his eyes, and a cattle dog. You know, no one needs to spend too long of a time to see that this dog wants a job and it wants to do stuff. So those are common pitta dogs. So what are some things that we can do for their food to add some cooling? That's the main idea here, obviously. So to answer your question, I saw somebody ask that just a little bit ago about coconut oil, Carol and Duff. Coconut oil is ideal for pitta. So here we have just some, you know, organic coconut oil, great for your dogs. You want to do like a teaspoon per 10 pounds. So you kind of want to go high on the coconut oil. Medicinal benefits are plenty through that. I won't get on to all of those details, although in my courses, you know, which by the way, we have one starting on Monday. The close of registration is tonight. So if anyone's like, oh my gosh, I love this conversation, this program is for you. It's called Ayurveda for Dogs 101. I'll mention it again in just a moment. But that is available, and that's where we really get into details. We work into all of this over 3 weeks. So for our pitta friends, we've got coconut oil and all the wonderful benefits of that. We also have cucumbers. I know you guys know what these wonderful foods look like, but I think it's wonderful to just kind of see, get the visual, get the energy of it, because the eyes are ingesting this just as much as the body is. So cucumbers, bananas, coconuts, all very good for cooling the heat of pitta. Also quinoa, you know, that's a good grain to add, a good source of protein also for your animals, and it has a cooling energy to it. So those are a few tips that you can bring into your pitta dog's diet as toppers. So again, why would you know? You either do the dosha quiz and you learn that they're pitta, and then you would align to this to keep them in balance, especially though when they're feeling overly heated. In this case, then you start to bring these in, and yeah, quinoa, thank you Kelly, then you start to bring these food choices in, and you start to notice your dog settle down or calm down or get more energized. So that's where we're on next. Energizing our kapha. That's our last dosha, K-A-P-H-A, kapha. Kapha is a combination of earth and water. When you bring earth and water together, what do you get? Mud, right? So just imagine that, like, kind of heavy, slow, stable energy. These dogs are loyal, easygoing, low maintenance, dependable, consistent, best friends, no drama kind of dogs when they're in balance. When they're out of balance, that earthy wateriness, that can become too much, which makes them more heavy, more inert, overweight, lazy, withdrawn, possessive, especially around food, because they're like, don't touch my food. I'm very concerned about this food. And also very grumpy. Typically, kaphas will get that. They also will get a lot of congestion going on in their body, where a pitta, by the way, will be more inflamed, the vata more dry, the pitta more inflamed. The kapha will become more congested. So it's goopy eyes, goopy ears, stinky paws, congestion around and in their body or in their joints. So those are all kapha conditions when out of balance. When we're looking at breeds, think, you know, all your mellow dogs, all of your golden retrievers, a lot of labs, Bernese mountain dog. We have a beautiful mixed Berner here, and she's as calm as could be, as kapha as could be. Pugs, bulldogs, basset hounds, you know, all of those kinds of King Charles Cavalier Spaniel. We have one that stays here at our boarding at our house, and he's so easy. So those kinds of dogs are kapha energy. Yes, lumps, Chris, that's exactly it. Lumps, lipomas. Super common for kapha dogs. So what do we do? What's the idea behind it? Is energizing, sprucing things up and getting things going. And then I'm going to be quiet so we can take some of your questions about these foods. But to tell you, the ideal kapha foods are green leafies. So we've got all of these, right? Well, spinach actually is great, but spinach is very good because it's cooling. So spinach is great for pitta dogs as well. To jump around here, but that's also a great cooling vegetable. So for our kaphas, where they need astringent, light, anti-inflammatory foods that, you know, that we would want to eat more of if we were dieting or trying to lose some weight, trying to detox. Think along those lines. So we've got celery, awesome source of fiber for dogs. You can chop it all up. Before I forget to say it, just when you're serving vegetables, with someone had asked, can we serve them to dogs? Definitely, yes. All the phytonutrients, free radical fighting, all of that is great. What we need to be careful of is if we're doing it raw, just mince them, almost like a puree or a salsa. Then the casein is broken down and your dogs can absorb them more easily. Green beans, one of my faves for all of our kapha friends, because they fills them up with more fiber, and then you can feed a little less food, helping them to alleviate. And then here we have Brussels sprouts. Those are a great fan favorite of most dogs too. Brussels sprouts and ghee, you know, you can always mix that together and get most dogs to eat them. Let me see if and ginger. I knew I was forgetting something. Ginger is a great food for kapha balancing. If you're a human and you recognize that you might be kapha or have some kapha imbalance, a little slice of it in hot water, make your own ginger tea, awesome. For dogs, you can put a slice in their water, just do a little bit at first, get them used to it. And then you can also just mince a bit and put it into their food, and they'll like that too. And it's very energizing, invigorating, stimulating, as mentioned, and that will serve them very well. So friends, those are a few tips for your doshas. Again, if you want to learn more with us, we have so many resources. We have, you can go to our website, check everything out, do the quiz at the first starting point. And then if you'd like to learn more, I invite you to take Ayurveda for Dogs 101. As mentioned, we start on Monday. Registration closes today. So I did want to extend to all of you, if you're interested in our course, to give you a coupon. Maybe someone on the line can jot that in, but it's COACH20, COACH20, and you could use that for $20 off if you did want to take our course. So that's that, my friends. So wonderful to connect with all of you. Let me know your questions. You're welcome to stay with me, and I know we have a little break time here, a little buffer, and then I want to let you go. So let me know how I can help. Thank you for listening. I hope this was interesting. So Kelly asks,
So you can be a combination of doshas. Yes, all of us are a combination of all three doshas. All of us. Now, some of us listening to this conversation might think, oh, it's just maybe I just have a little bit of one of those doshas. And that's probably true. But yes, we all have all three. Most of us have one that is more predominant, as mentioned, and then a good majority has two. Like for me personally, Pitta and Vata are in pretty equal combination for me. And you can find out your own. You know, you could even go to Chopra.com. That's Deepak Chopra's organization, and they have a great human dosha quiz there. I'm just going to scroll up and see. Can I rewatch this? Paula, yes. Everything will be recorded and available for you to rewatch later. Chris can probably guide us a little bit more on that. And just looking through your questions. Coconut oils. Confused whether we can use veggies, so we address that. All right. Well, if anyone wants to stay in and ask questions, then feel free. I am here. If you want to head out to your networking opportunity, then please feel free to do that. I hope to stay in touch with every single one of you. Thank you. Namaste, my friends. Is there a list of additional foods? Yes. Oh, I meant to say, on the Sama Dog, when you do the dosha quiz, you will be guided, you'll get an email afterwards, and you'll be guided to our resources page. It's also samadog.com/doshas, D-O-S-H-A-S. Right there, you will see it broken down, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha, and you'll see different, all kinds of different suggestions, some of what I mentioned here, but more, and then even some other foods, some practices, some general ideas to keep in mind to balance each of the doshas. So those are all free resources to you on our page, so have at it. And let me know if you have any questions. Also, I'm always available for you guys. Shoot me an email, connect@SamaDog, or you can find me on here. You can just take the business card, Amanda@SamaDog, and we'll keep on sharing all of this. We do put out into the world every week a meditation with your animal as well. So if you're into that, if you like to have a practice, then get on our list, and then you'll every Monday we'll send you a new meditation. Next week's is about the human canine bond. It's beautiful. Last week was about rain and had like rain sounds in the background to meditate to. So lots of cool stuff like that. My dog loves the meditations. Oh, Terry, I'm so glad. Are you doing them? Are you doing arm meditation, or do you mean in general meditation? All very good. Puppies, any thought on balancing their diets? Kelly, great question. Yes, you know, in general, puppies are kapha dosha. So what we want to do, because they're building, you know, there's that time in our life, whether we're children or, you know, babies and kids or puppies. So we're building. Oh, that's great, Terry. But building the body, building the knowledge, building experiences, and building, you know, the life behind us. And so with that, you want to kind of lean towards nourishment and more calories. It's a little counterintuitive because we want to, with kapha, watch our calories. But in puppies' cases, they could have more calories, but you do want to kind of just keep it very fresh and light and healthy so that they get all that nourishment that they need. And then just making sure, and you probably know this, but 3, even 4 meals a day for puppies I found is really good, because then it creates more balance in their belly, in their digestion, which creates more balance in their mind. They're not going from full to hungry to full to hungry. And then they stay more balanced in their behavior. It's remarkable how tied our dog's behavior is to their gut, to specifically their gut biome. That's not my topic today. I'm sure someone else will be talking about that, but it's a very interesting one to explore. Terry says, in fact, she heard your voice on the session and came over to lay down and sprawled out. She recognizes you. Oh, that's so sweet. Makes me want to cry. That's beautiful. I love that, Terry. All right, friends. Well, I'm going to stay here just because I want to be able to help you and answer questions, but I don't want you to feel, you know, obligated. So I hope you enjoy the rest of this event so much. Favorite source of probiotics. I carry a line of herbs that is specifically made Ayurvedically. And so they carry a probiotic that I love. This specific brand is called Ayush, A-Y-U-S-H. They make human Ayurvedic herbs. And they also label many of them for dogs and cats as well. And we carry that at Sama Dog, that whole line. They make a probiotic, I think it's called It's like 100B. I think that's what the name of it is, probiotic 100B. You would see it on our Sama Dog site under products, or just Google Ayush, but theirs is great. Another probiotic that I haven't tried myself, but I just recently learned about, and I'll do a little bit for her there, is Julie Ann from the Adored Beast Apothecary, an awesome company that has all kinds of good products also. They have a new probiotic that she's just come out with that is specifically made for dogs. From the holistic vets that I love learning from, they often will share that dogs, you know, all these probiotics that we've been giving our animals all this time, they're made for humans. So yes, certainly some of those microbes are the same, but some are not. And so it doesn't really make sense what we're doing here. And therefore, especially in modern science, probiotics aren't as heavily recommended as they once were. More is diversity and a lot of variety in the diet. So that said, dog-specific probiotics are where the industry seems to be heading. And it sounds like the Adored Beast. Yeah, oh, there you go. I use Adored Beast Phyto's Flora. Excellent product. Thank you, Chris. You're a wealth of knowledge. I see why you love doing this. So yeah, they're great. All of those products that she has are excellent. And I loved when she was on our show. We do a monthly show. When she was on there, she explained her probiotics, and I really noticed a difference in that. I read Wiesla's, Chris says. Oh, that's great. Wiesla's. I wonder what dosha, Chris. Do you know what dosha they tend to be? I'm wondering. I'm thinking Pitta and Vata, but I don't know them like you know them, so I'd be interested in that. Well, you said I had one definite Vata. Oh, yeah, you said that. Ruth says, what dosha is a Tibetan terrier? Every single being, it depends. Every single being is uniquely different. But in general, terriers are working breeds. Terriers are that more focused, kind of want to do stuff, be active, have a job, get a lot of exercise every day. And those are more Pitta animals that need that kind of constant digestion of life. And then Chris has another kapha and a pitta. So that's interesting. So your Wiesla, you even have a Wiesla that's kapha. So Chris, that's a perfect example right there. Kapha is usually in my breed. Kapha is unusual in my breed. Yes, I was going to say that. I would think so. But what is interesting is that you do have a kapha that is that breed. And so that just shows all of our participants today that, you know, we can't really categorize it in that way. It's about getting to know our own animal, do the quiz. And they always change, you know. So Chris, what might be going on with your dog? And let me ask you, is your dog a little overweight right now? Are they in like a stage of that imbalance, or have they always just been a grounded, more kind of solid character? Hi, Paula, I'm sorry to come in very late. Can you give me a link so I can learn more about you? I have a Bichon, what can you say about her? Bichon? Typically are Vata Pitta. They tend towards nervousness in some cases. I know many of my clients come with a Bichon that has some sort of issues, either anxiety and like separation problems or skin problems. So it kind of depends what is going on with your dog, if it's more heat or more ungrounded, to answer that question correctly. She is quite unique. So Chris is talking about his Kapha Wiesla. She is a very grounded dog, and she's currently in a false pregnancy. So helping her through the stodgy stage is important. Oh, interesting. Yeah, that's fascinating how that also is going on with her. That's almost like stagnation, not stagnation. If it was a real pregnancy, of course that is not. Since it's a false pregnancy, it's like a holding on, right? That's what kaphas do, they hold. So that's, I would love to hear more about that. Paula, especially in the car. LOL, she is anxious. Oh, your Bichon, she's anxious. Yeah, so I would say Vata. So when you go back and watch this, if you came in late and you didn't get the food tips, just, or go to our page, to that dosha's page, and figure out what you could bring into her life to put on her food to bring more solidity, more warmth, moisture. That'll make a difference.
That's my dog. My dog is extremely anxious. She
really?
She had four previous owners before I did, and she spent several stints in the dog pound. She was a severely aggressive dog, and she's a lot happier. And you know, I've had her for about 4 years now, and she's doing wonderful. But she's a very anxious dog still.
Well, that's interesting, Stephen, because it sounds like her, if she was reactive and aggressive, that means that pitta was coming out in her. Mm-hmm. But now it's more vata. More of that fear and ungroundedness. So
yes.
So one thing that I didn't mention, just to say real quick, is I make these elixir oils. So they look like this. They're on our site. And so for Vata, this would actually be the Vata one. It's a calming elixir. It's called Tranquil.
Oh, that's what she needs. Yes.
Yeah, and I have one for Pitta and Kapha. And so it's an oil. This, in this case of Vata, it would be sesame oil. So that's, you know, it's just organic, cold pressed, fractionated, so it's very absorbable. But we also have flower essences in there. So that works with the mind. That's why these elixirs are pretty cool. You would just drop some over the food each meal. And they help the body mind. So that's something that many clients that I've worked with, that they'll see a big difference from just some of these simple energetics. Because vatas are very sensitive. You know, that airiness in them creates a sensitivity. So that's why, though, they respond very well to energy work. They are really in tune to that sort of thing. So meditations with her, I highly recommend you try out a couple of those, Stephen. Everybody's going to benefit, and she would like it.
I'll check them out. I'm willing to try anything. I mean, she's, for the most part, her aggressiveness has completely gone away. It's taken a lot of work. But she's still very sensitive to sound. You know, any sound, any bump in the night, and it scares her. She shakes and she trembles, and it stresses her out. Whenever, you know, she gets so nervous, she ends up becoming nauseous, or, you know, it affects her bowels, you know, she'll have diarrhea from it. So she's very sensitive in that regard. I know whenever I drop her off at the groomers, she's just shaking. I mean, it's terrible, and she's guaranteed to have diarrhea for the next couple of days after that.
Yeah, we should work together a little bit. We should do a call. I do free 20-minute consults. So
that'd be wonderful. Yeah,
we should just have a quick call, and I'll give you suggestions. And yeah, because what you want to do, what we've talked about, right, is balance the core. So we're not so much treating when she goes to the groomer, when she hears the sound. We're treating the core to bring her back to like a stable inside. And then doesn't mean it'll go away completely.
Sure.
Definitely lessen.
Okay.
Yeah. I got this. You know, that's always the mantra that I hear in their mind when they go, I got this. I know I'm okay. That sound doesn't scare me anymore.
That's what my mom says. She says her name's Olivia, my dog. She says Olivia's just not very confident. And I'm like, that's what it seems like. She just seems very insecure.
Yeah, but you can build that. You can build that in her. Mm-hmm. Just your intentions and, you know, all of that can help a lot.
And she really has improved a great deal. I mean, she was a red zone dog when I got her. She was severely aggressive, but she's, I would like to, you know, make some improvement.
Yeah, good job. It's not easy. It's, you know, very courageous and a service to adopt a dog like that in the first place. So thank you for doing that and turning her around like this. She's lucky to have you. Chris says, I'm hoping that Ayurvedic support will help her too. I do pick my dogs, the ones who stay with me and our family from the litter, to be harmonious. So I like her deep, wise, grounded personality as a pup to balance the more fiery characters. Chris, you are totally like Mr. Ayurveda. This is great. I'm assuming Chris is a male. I shouldn't make these assumptions. But I see that you really are getting this. Fiery characters, I look at the whole family's balance and harmony, need them to work together, not fight each other. That's exactly it, Chris. And you know what's interesting? It brings my mind to the fact that when we decide to, we had all the fosters flying through here all those times, right? And when we would decide to keep a dog, have a permanent addition to our pack, we always consider the doshas. And we very mindfully in this house have a Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. And then we have one that's pretty tri-doshic, that's what it's called, that kind of helps blend the middle point. And it does help a lot. And I think about that with households that have the same breed, and needing to be even more specific with the personality, which is exactly what you've learned to do. So that's really interesting. Is stagnation. Oh, Krista said use Chinese herbs. Yeah, those are great. Also Chinese, all of the traditional Chinese medicine and Ayurveda is very closely aligned. You guys might notice that even just with the temperatures of food and the animal, you want to warm them up or cool them down, etc. It's very closely aligned because traditional Chinese medicine comes from Ayurveda. Ayurveda being the oldest system on the world, apparently, you know, started in the ancient civilization. And then from that, all of these other techniques coming from them. So they remain very close. You know, even the terminology, prana and chi and, you know, many, many more like that.
Amanda, I see Paula here. She asked, she mentioned rotation of proteins. Mm-hmm. Do you have a favorite protein that you feed, or does it just depend on the dog, their needs?
It depends on the needs of the dog. Okay. However, there are ideal proteins for each of the doshas. Mm-hmm. So for just a nutshell, vata, you want more grounding animals mm-hmm. that are also a bit warming meat. So like beef is good, bison, buffalo. I don't know why they're all the bee animals, but you can they're these like big, heavy, slow creatures, right? Mm-hmm. So that's the energy that will come into your dog when they eat them. You want to avoid chicken with vatas because okay. think of chicken. We even have the same, right? Chicken with mm-hmm. your head cut off. So they're like, ooh, they spin out of control. So for a vata, you don't want that.
Okay.
Now, so pitta, then we would want more cooling meats, cooling proteins. So I would say the best choice there is duck. But turkey is a neutral because, you know, sometimes we can't find duck. So turkey is nicely neutral.
Mm-hmm.
And then with kapha, we want light and energizing. So there we would choose chicken. Ideally, like, you know, chicken just tends to sometimes trigger allergies. So you just want to get like,
yes.
But chicken would be good. Turkey, even like some lamb, something like that could be great for a kapha that helps kind of stimulate. Fish, white fish, ideally for kapha because it's light. Think of even just like a person that was looking to lighten up some, you know, you'd eat a lot of like white meats and mm-hmm. veggies, and that's exactly what we would do with our dogs as well.
Yeah, my dog is terrible on any kind of poultry. I cannot feed her chicken or turkey. She gets instant hot spots like in a matter of days all over. And so
that's interesting. So with your dog, it sounds like, and what you told me already about mm-hmm. that side, so I think your dog's predominantly pitta mm-hmm. but has a little bit of a vata imbalance. That's where that fear and phobia yeah. comes. But that pitta, because an animal that at its core is kind of fiery and heated, when okay. you add hot food to it, it's like giving them jalapenos. You know, it's like giving
yes. jalapenos.
Yes. They're going to lash out and spit fire like a dragon, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that. So the body, you know, the dog can't say to us, I don't like that. It's overly hot. It makes me feel so uncomfortable, that food. So it's really their body and their behavior that speaks for them. And you see it with the.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. So in tune. Good job. Great. Well, you guys know where to find me. Oh, I didn't scroll. I didn't see there were more questions. Paula, I've had her 11 years home cook with low starchy veggies and of course rotation of proteins. Yeah. And rotation, I meant to say that. Rotation is the key. Rotation of everything, whether it's the protein, whether it's the brand, if you're feeding, you know, some of these amazing brands that you're learning about, I'm sure today in this conference, like Hamsters and Small Batch and Primal and Raw Bistro and all of these awesome brands that give us really good raw foods. Even then, switch brands, change up the brands, use different farms. Those animals are eating different foods in different parts of the country, breathing different air. All of their microbiome is completely different then, and what is going to come into our animal is different. And so the veggies, getting them from different farmers markets, you know, things like that, is the people who are studying, who are on the cutting edge of gut biome health and the huge understanding that we're getting more and more of the importance of that in our body. They say that is the most important thing. Like getting little pieces of dirt basically from everywhere around the world, as many different kinds of places that you can. And that is the essential way to live and be healthy. So our dogs are the same. Bronwyn says, I've got an Australian cattle dog, so full-blown vata. Okay. But she's got an anxiety aggression almost, but it seems to be almost like a nervous tick, but with her mouth. So she will bite another dog's lips or legs continuously. What dosha would this fall into? I would say definitely you're right on with a combination of vata and pitta. When in doubt, go towards vata. They call vata the king of the doshas. And that is because the air is most mobile and influencing all of the other doshas. When you look at the elements, think of the way that air influences fire. When the big Santa Anas are happening right here in California, right? All fire season picks up because air feeds fire. So if your animal has airiness and fieriness, that air is just going to make the fire worse all the time. So bring down the air first, that wind, stop the wind, and then it will cease the fire as well. So that's the approach to take, Bronwyn, in your, with your dog. Sorry, Pitta, you said. Yeah, you said Pitta or Vata, but I do think that you have both going on with your dog there. So yeah, kind of see how that works. I would need to ask a few more questions, really, as far as, like, you know, is your animal, does it act hot? Is it favoring cool temperatures, like putting its belly on the, you know, tile and whatnot? Is it panting a lot? Does it feel hot to the touch when you touch the paws? Things like that. That's a good gauge of the doshas as well.
Amanda, I'm going to hop off. Sandra asked for me to go to the next session. Yeah, thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, thank you.
It was nice to meet you.
Yeah, you too. See you later. And thank you all so much. If anyone has anything else to share, please do. But of course, just email me. We'll stay in touch. Thank you for being here today. Thank you truly deeply for taking the time to care for your animals this way. It makes all the difference for them. They'll be with us so much longer because of that. Thank you, everyone. Take care.